Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. We are all here today, so smash that like button for Ronnie J, because his style was something that I was like naturally drawn to. And he was one of those producers where like, oh, Ronnie J produced that? No wonder I like the beat. No wonder I like the song, because Ronnie J was behind it. So he was behind a lot of dope songs. Name your favorite song that you found out about Ronnie J from, or which artist you found out about Ronnie J from. The grammar of that is terrible, so smash that like button to get me some English classes. Today I'm going to show you how to get your 808 to sound really crunchy, distorted, and different levels of it, because a lot of people teaching you this just tell you to just turn up your 808. The problem with that is that you're going to kill your whole mix for your other sounds, so you won't be able to hear your whole song if you just crank your 808 all the way up. You're not going to get the same result. You have to gain stage, you have to do all this stuff. So I'll show you a couple ways you can be creative with your 808 mix. So let me just quickly create like a chord progression. Let's grab scalar. Shout out to MG the Future for putting me on the scalar. I know there's like a new one right now, but whatever. This is scalar. You can click MG's link. It's an affiliate link, so it's not my link. It's his link for scalar. So shout out to MG for putting me onto this. But I only use it for a couple things. Scale detection and then mapping out what are called the scale degrees. So let's start with a scale, and let's just start with C minor. Let's grab that one and see how it automatically maps out the chords per the note within the scale. I know I'm speaking music theory and ease to you right now, but if you're new, we've trained over 600,000 producers around the world. I've trained people on the billboards. I've trained people to get awards. I've trained people around the world, literally, and work with the top companies in the audio space. So I'm just showing you tricks of the modern producer. So anyway, go to style and you could change out the chords. So you can add a little finesse to it by making this a seventh chord, for example. And then you just click on the blue stuff and listen to the chord. So you pick the chords you want. So like. Kind of like this. So I mean, you could sit there and go through your favorite chord progression. We're not going to harp on that, but let's open up a sound source. Hermes, I'm going to open up my own plugin here. Shout out to my team. I got to shout out Josh. I got to shout out Martin. I got to shout out Aaron, my team behind this. And there were other teammates behind this, so I got to thank everybody who was a part of the process, but those are the key players with me. So anyway, with this plugin Hermes, I'm just going to grab something lightweight like a bell. Let's go with Farm Bells, and then I'm going to grab an 808. So we have to start with music so we can understand what's going on. So in Scalar, let's grab the chord progression from here. It says drag MIDI. Just drag that into your plugin of choice, preferably Hermes. Okay, and we're going to grab this. So hit Control A, hit Alt, and then left click and just drag this out. So it's like double the length, because with trap music, everything's double the length. So we're at 160 BPM, so stuff has to be a little bit longer. So our chord progression, if you go to pattern mode, sounds like that. And you can hit Control down. Okay, so now we have like a vibe. Now we can make it different. I don't want to get too deep into sound design, but you could turn up the vibrato here to give it a little flavor and a little spread. There you go. So now it has a little life to it. So let's drag this into the playlist. Now we need an 808. So the reason I prefaced it with the music is because the music makes the 808 sound right or not. Like if your 808 is not matching with the bottom note of the music, it's going to sound clashing from the start. So you're going to have a lot of phase issues. And when you go to distort your 808, it's not going to sound right. You're going to have like a lot of wobbly distortion. It's not going to sound like proper distortion. So let's find an 808. I really like the 808s from Split Mind. It's called Split Mind now. But Split Mind, shout out to Half from Split Mind. The BWB is not BusyWorks Beats. It's Big White Beats. But shout out to them. Like an 808 from here. Okay, so we're gonna grab a nice short 808, and let's just grab a kick and a snare from here. Okay, now moving a little quick. We need a bounce snare, we need a hard snare. This could be a bounce snare, and then we need something to kind of land on. Let's use that to land on. And we need a hi-hat for this all to make sense. Let's do a simple hi-hat. Let's right-click, open that up. So now we have the elements. Let's just highlight everything. Go to your mixer, right click insert one, and go to channel routing, route selected channel starting from this track. So now everything's routed properly in the mixer. So in pattern three, let's start building out that drum rhythm first before we get to the 808 rhythm. Again, you have to make sure the phase of all this stuff lines up. So we have a kick is very similar to an 808 in its phase. It's like the way the waves line up. So if you start with your kick first, so you know that your kick's going to hit, and then you can pivot your 808 off of your kick. That's why we have delayed 808s in modern music. So let's create a very, 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 very basic snare rhythm. Okay, just super simple. Okay, super simple and bouncy. So then we need to add our landing snares, which are the main snares on the 3 and the 7 count. I can't get into everything about everything. Like, if you want to learn a lot of the technique of music production, go to musicproducerunion.com. We have a ton of training for you. Or go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. Take it to the same page. Okay, so now we have 2 snares working. Okay, again, all this is extremely important because you have to know where your kick will be for your 808 to hit the hardest. And I'm showing you all the little stuff getting to the 808 because it's extremely important. You can't just turn the 808 all the way up and expect your song to hit. You have to level it out right. And that's why I'm showing you all the elements combined. And I'll show you what the mistake people make going in. Okay, so make sure you have your pattern. Let's speed it up a little bit, it's a little slow. Okay, so things are leveled, they're called, in the mixer. You're not adding any plugins, it's just how loud it is in the mixer. So now let's go and let's add an 808 pattern to it. And now the 808 could potentially clash with the kick because, again, they have very similar frequencies. So if you make your 808 hit at the same time as your kick, chances are they'll clash. See how they're clashing? Firstly, right click your 808, make sure it says cut itself. Sometimes the program doesn't automatically do that. That will definitely make sure it doesn't clash, but you heard that wobble effect? It's because they're stacking up frequencies that are similar. So it's here, I'm gonna keep this short. Easy bass lines line up with the kick, okay? For the most part, your bass line probably sounds off because your bass doesn't line up with your kick. So for trap music, it's extremely important that they line up at least at key points. Okay, so now we need to give the 808 a note. So let's right click, go to piano roll, and we need to go boom. So what I do is I pull all the notes up an octave, control up, so I can hear the tone, and then I hit shift up and down till we get to the right note. Then you hit control. Actually, it's a little sharp. So I'm gonna go to the sample, go to the pitch range, pull this down to 1, and then pull it down. Actually, it was a little flat. That's another thing about when you add distortion, you have to actually change the pitch because the pitch perception will change once you add saturation and distortion, but we're not there yet. So hit control down. But see how the 808 and the kick are like fighting for attention? So the first step you need to do is turn up your headphones at this point so that everything becomes louder. And then now it's weird hearing myself loud, so I'm gonna turn mine down for a second. But you wanna grab all your sounds, left click and pull all the sounds down. So now you have what's called headroom. You have room to turn up the volume. And here's where you start leveling the 808 and the kick. So what the mistake people do is let me show you the mistake before we get into the proper way. Let's return these back to their normal. There's no quick way to do this, I guess. Okay, so turn it back to its normal. Now the mistake people make is they just crank their 808. Now I have on my master track a Fruity Soft Clipper just because it adds crunch to the beat, a little bit of crunch when you clip it intentionally. But the problem with a soft clipper on the master track is that if you don't leave enough headroom, you have to understand headroom before you just use this as a crutch. Let's just keep it that simple. So what people do is they'll crank up the 808 because they want the 808 to hit harder, so they just turn up the volume. And you hear this nasty distortion. It's like a bad saturation. I'm gonna turn the master down so we don't blow our ears out. And then I'm just gonna overly crank the 808. So as I talk, it's like you can't even hear my voice. My voice gets distorted because the 808 is just so loud. So that's the problem with overly turning up your 808. Now, sometimes you want the song to sound distorted when the 808 hits and it wobbles the whole song. But if you notice the Look At Me song, I know Ronnie J might not have been behind that one. I think actually Producer Grind did a breakdown of that beat. But the Look At Me song by XXXTentacion, RIP, they actually remixed the song. Because if you listen to the initial version, it just distorted the whole track. And then the new music video version that they put up on YouTube and stuff, they didn't distort the whole track. They remixed it to where the 808 had distortion, but it wasn't wobbling the whole song. So they actually redid the mix properly. I can't say properly, right or wrong, but I'm just saying they did it to where it didn't distort the entire song. So the first step is turn up your headphones at this point, turn them up, and then turn all the sounds down. So let's, in FL Studio, the sounds are really loud by default. Just turn it down. And now you can start leveling your track. So you can start creating priority of sounds. So if you want the impact of the kick to be more important, turn your kick up. If you want the 808 to kind of be more of the dominant force and just the kick to just add a little thump, you can have the 808 above the kick. There's no right or wrong. It depends on the style of song. And just from here, you just start turning stuff up until you can hear it. And this is like half of mixing right here, is just getting the levels right. Let's not say half, maybe like 20%. It's a big part of it though. Now the 808 sounds kind of saturated by default. So let's get into some saturation techniques. The first is there's two different types of distortion. In short, there's saturation and then there's distortion. So there's like soft distortion and then there's hardcore distortion. I'll just show you on a plugin called Decapitator. Because this plugin has two different modes. So one is regular mode, which is just turning the drive knob up. So that's something like sausage fattener. It just saturates the sound. It goes from to, okay. Whereas distortion goes from to, you know, it becomes a completely shredded sound, literally. So you can mess with the knob here. And see how as soon as you get past a certain point, it becomes distortion versus like a light buzzy saturation. Now you gotta be really careful. I can't get into everything about everything, but we do have mixing and mastering courses at musicproducerunion.com. So you can get that training there. There's actually a free trial for you as well. But you would have to blend this. You wouldn't just turn everything all the way wet, it's called, or like fully the effect. You would blend the effect in. That way you can push it without taking away some of the original sound. Now, if we put it on punish mode, it'll turn into pure distortion instead of saturation. If I turn this up, it'll be obvious. So this is more of the Ronnie J realm. He experiments with different distortion more than saturation. So this would be like his style. So it has enough punch. The reason I'm showing you all these little nuances is because if you don't start from back in the knowledge of getting the sounds leveled, picking the right sounds, mapping it out right, you're gonna have issues with getting your 808 to hit, because your 808 is not just about the effects you put on it. Because when you add distortion plugins, you're gonna be like, why is my 808 sound thin? It's because a lot of things. So that's why I showed you this whole process. So we can crank this up. And there's different distortion plugins. You can go Decapitator, you can go Isotope, Exciter. I use it a lot on triode mode, so I'll segment out the low end only and then turn it on triode mode. So that gives you that saturation without taking it to distortion. Now, distortion would be more of tape, even though it's saturation, but I don't think, which maybe the tube will give you more high end. See how it's more thin, whereas the triode just focuses on creating harmonics, making it thicker. So you have Isotope Exciter, you have Decapitator, you have Sausage Fattener, distortion plugins, you have, what else is there? There's a bunch of stuff from UA, Universal Audio. I mean, but there's Guitar Rig you could experiment with. They have a bunch of distortion pedals. Just make sure you turn it on left and right so that you get the stereo feed, just in case you have other effects. You would go to components, you would go to distortion and try out different things. Like the Screamer models the Ibanez Tube Screamer. So So, I mean, it gives you different styles of distortion, but I'm not really a fan of distortion. I feel like it's all, Guitar Rig kind of sums it up. There's like these different styles of distortion. There's fuzz, there's the screamer kind of saturation, light distortion, there's basically that's it. And I mean, all the other ones are just like really nuanced harmonic differences. You can't even really tell that much. But you see, when I turned that bass knob up, it allowed the bass again, whereas before it was thin. So when you got to be careful when you're using distortion, you're going to be like, where did my low end go? That's a pretty cool sound. Sounds really good, actually. So there's, again, there's different styles, but as long as you categorize it in your head as saturation, distortion, you're gonna have a lot easier time of navigating through all the plugin options. Again, I mean, do I recommend any plugin specifically? I don't really recommend anything, especially when it comes to saturation or distortion. My favorite plugin though is Universal Audio Thermionic Culture Vulture. So this costs a lot of money to even begin to get it. So that's why I'm not like, I recommend this $800. It's just, this is my favorite one. That's why it's my favorite. I'll just say that. But here, I'll show you what I can do with it. So when you turn that drive knob up, it's going to make it sound more saturated. See how it sounds like bubbly? Then you can push it harder and harder. This is without even getting into the real... Let's take it back to the beginning. And then you can put it in an overdrive mode, which is like multiplying the drive knob. I like this level right here. I'd probably keep it right here. Smooth sound. Then again, you have to mess with the mix level to make sure you're still getting the low end you want. I don't want to get too geeky though. But anyway, just turn this up. Now we're in that destructive distortion. But again, it sounds thin, so you gotta like bring back the original. You gotta have a blend. But I don't like that hard sound for this specific track. I liked it where I had it. Forgot where I had it. Just somewhere around here. Like just bubbly enough. So I'm just showing you all the ways you can get the Ronnie J sound. There's another Isotope plugin, I think Isotope Trash it's called. It can add a lot more distortion colors to it as well. FL has some native plugins like Fruity Fast Distort. It's not my favorite sound, that's all. I just don't really prefer the sound. You could use this. Put an A mode, B mode. You can use Fruity Wave Shaper. And then what you would do is you right click a point and just slowly drag this to the top left. Make it buzzy. Now let me turn down the post level here. But it sounds too like Bit Crusher for me. Then what else? FL has Fruity Blood Overdrive. This is more of like a preamp style. Preamp. So turn the post gain down, turn the preamp up. And you'll get more of that bubbly. But again, everything sounds different. So you're not gonna get the same feel. And I guess if you want that overdrive effect, you would hit the times 100 button. So I'm going to make sure to save my ears that this post gain is all the way down before I turn this knob up. Then we get that shredded sound. Now in this song, I would definitely prioritize the kick. Because if you're gonna have a lightweight 808, you want the kick to kind of move it. Oh, that was dirty. That was so dirty right there. Another trick, so your kick and 808 don't clash, just go to your wrench tool, turn up time shift a little bit. Just a little bit though. Now this song doesn't really need it. So treat your distorted 808 like a distorted electric guitar and rock and just go crazy with it. Shout out to Ronnie J for bringing that sound. I really love that distinctive risk he took by distorting the 808s. I think it's my favorite, one of my favorite sounds to mess with is a distorted 808 or a saturated 808. So shout out to Ronnie J. That is how you can use his distortion effects. I know we went through the whole process, but if you didn't see it in context and I just showed you a bunch of plugins, you wouldn't even be doing it right. You'd be just adding plugins and wondering why your song doesn't sound like his. So thank you for watching today. Again, to learn more, go to musicproducerunion.com. We have a ton of training for you. We're going to change the world for music producers around the world. This is something massive and it's a big initiative and we need all the cool people to help out behind the scenes. So cool people, if you're watching, yes, we want you to be a part of this thing. So thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. And again, Hermes will be out soon enough. So more information on that soon. So thanks for watching. Smash that like button. Subscribe if you're new. It's busyworksbeats.com.